everyone, it's Nina. Today, I'm covering the topic that's been highly requested, how to use layers. Specifically, I'll be talking about mask layers. There are many types of mask layers and way to use them, but I recommend only these two methods. If you master just these two techniques, you'll boost your workflow efficiency and finish your art faster. Ready? Let's get started. I won't go into the technical definition of mask layers here. We're jumping straight into practical applications. Okay? To make things clear, let's start by changing the background color. Clipping is a simple but incredibly useful tool to prevent your colors from spilling over the edges when painting. Let's explain with an example using a club chair. Right now, the club chair is painted with a flat white color. This is our base layer. I'll explain how to set it up well later, don't worry. If you add a new layer above it and clip it to the base layer, watch this. Even if you scrap the color all over randomly, the paint only shows up where the base layer has color. Now, let me remove the clipping for a moment. See how messy it gets? But when you enable clipping again, voila! No paint goes outside the base layer's boundaries. The best part about clipping is that it lets you paint boldly and freely without worrying about staying inside the lines. For example, when painting this club chair, if you are someone like me who enjoys watercolor or light and oil paint, heavy layering techniques, clipping is a lifesaver. Even if you layer colors randomly, as long as you clip the layer, the paint stays within the boundaries of the white base layer. This is especially helpful for creating gradients or blending multiple colors. It's an invaluable tool for artists who like experimenting with colors like I do. And look at that! In just about a minute, the club chair is completely painted. This technique isn't limited to club chairs, of course. You can use it for faces, hair, or any other parts you want to separate into layers. By creating base layers for each part and clipping above them, you can color freely without worrying about stills. Isn't it great? Okay, now how to use. Start with a line drawing. Select the line drawing layer, then use the out selection tool to choose the areas you want to color. Make sure your out selection tool is set to allow multiple selections here. Next, click here to create a new layer and place it below the line art layer. While keeping this new created layer selected, go to the Edit tab, choose Fill, and fill it with the color of your choice. For those who want to create a watercolor effect, I recommend filling it with white. I personally use white most of the time, but you can use any color you like. After that, create one more new layer and click here, this part right here. Do you see the red line that appears on the left side of the layer? This red line indicates that the new layer is clipped to the layer below it. In this case, it means the new layer is clipped to the base layer that we filled with white. And finally, select the clipped layer and paint however you like. The colors will only appear in the areas painted on the base layer. Okay. I was planning to share a technique for speeding up the process of creating base layers for multiple parts, but this video is already quite long, so for now, I'll just focus on explaining how to use clipped layer. In a future video, I'll share tips on how to quickly divide parts into layers. The base layers, even if you're someone who finds it tedious, so stay tuned for that. Also, sometimes you might notice that the edge of your line looks wide or like they're floating. I cover how to fix issues like that in another video. Now, let's move on to the second technique, mask layers. Imagine you initially draw a girl holding a piece of paper, but later you decide you'd rather have her holding the game controller. Yes, she is the gamer, and by the way, I love gaming too. If you try to erase the paper and ask the controller directly, it could get tricky. What if you erase too much and decide later you want to change it back? If you've saved over the original, you'd have to start all over. This is where mask layers come in handy. When working professionally, clients often request revisions like, move this to the right. Or, actually, I liked it better when this part was visible. It happens. To handle these changes without damaging the original artwork, mask layers are a lifesaver. Of course, this is very useful not only in work situations, but also when you want to make your own corrections later. Here's how they work. Select the layer you want to mask and click here to add a mask. Now, with the mask layer selected, use the eraser tool to adjust the image. If you erase too much, don't worry. Simply use the paint tool to draw over the masked area, and the original artwork will reappear. Since you're only editing the mask layer, the original artwork underneath remains untouched. Even after erasing boldly like this, you can restore the original image by adding color back to the mask layer. For example, if you later decide the character should press the A button instead of the X button, you can adjust the controller and mask layer without altering the original illustrations. Mask layers are perfect for temporary edits or adjustments you might want to revisit later. When adjusting an object, lowering the opacity makes it easier to work. Today, we covered two useful techniques, clipping layers and mask layers. These are methods I personally use to speed up my workflow and create art more efficiently. If you're interested in learning more detailed techniques, I'll cover them in future videos. For now, though, I encourage you to dive in and experiment. It's the best way to learn. Okay, thank you for sticking with me through this longer video. I hope to see you again in the next one. Happy drawing and take care. Have a great drawing day. Bye-bye.